Hey guys, how's it going? Today I'll be showing you guys how to kill elves, but before I start this video, if you're looking for more Slayer guides, please check out the description box below for a full list of all the guides I have posted thus far. Enjoy the rest of the video. So I'm going to break up this guide into three different parts. The first part is important information, and we'll cover everything you need to know on how to decide your armor setup and location. The second section will go over everything you need to know on selecting your armor, and you can choose which attack style fits your needs. The third section will go over each location, including how to travel there, what your inventory and quick pairs might look like, and I'll also provide you with an in-game example in which you can follow along with me. So we'll begin with important information, and we'll go over two things. First are the combat stats, so you have a better feel for the difficulty of killing elves. The second part will go over the pros and cons of all four locations, and these two things should help you decide what armor setup and location you want to use for this Slayer task. So there are two kinds of elves. There are rangers and warriors, and killing any of these two will count towards an elf Slayer task. Looking at the important characteristics, the rangers have a combat level of 90, while the warriors are 108. The rangers have a max hit of 11, while the warriors have a max hit of 10. Rangers and warriors only use one attack style, the rangers only attack with range, and the warriors only attack with melee. In terms of the attack speed and interval, the rangers will attack with an interval of 3 seconds, while the warriors attack every 2.4 seconds. Both monsters are not aggressive, except for certain instances such as entering the Mourner headquarters and taking off your armor, or if you go to the Ireworth camp while you're still finishing up the Song of the Elves quest. Lastly, rangers and warriors can only be found in certain locations, so I've listed them all here, but we'll talk more about the pros and cons of each location in the next section. Anyways, we'll talk a bit more about the combat stats of the rangers, but the most powerful stats are 105 hit points, 80 defense, and 90 range, so they are pretty strong and will hit pretty accurately. It has no attacking bonuses, which is always good, and also has some pretty high defensive bonuses. You can see that it's most efficient to kill it with a stab attack style or a ranged attack style because they are both at plus 50. Slash, crush, and magic attack styles are still completely fine to use, but they are definitely less efficient in terms of the attack styles. Lastly, they are not immune to poison or venom, so using those weapons can help to speed up your Slayer task. Now looking at the combat stats of the warriors, the most powerful stats are 105 hit points, 95 attack, 95 strength, as well as 80 defense, so they are pretty strong and will hit pretty accurately. It has no attacking bonuses, which is always good, and also has some pretty high defensive bonuses. It's most efficient to kill it with a stab attack style or a ranged attack style because they are both at plus 50. Slash, crush, and magic attack styles are still completely fine to use, but they are definitely less efficient in terms of the attack styles. Lastly, they are not immune to poison or venom, so using these types of weapons can help to speed up your Slayer task. In terms of the overall difficulty between killing the rangers and the warriors, they pretty much hit with the exact same power and accuracy, and they give almost the exact same Slayer XP as well. So the only difference really is in the attack speed, and this is mostly important for the people who choose to use one of the tank setups or the melee defensive setups, because killing the rangers that attack with a slower interval will use up less supplies and help with your efficiency. If you're using one of the prayer setups, however, you really don't have to worry too much about attack speed because protection prayers will fully protect you. Anyways, that is just some of the basic information on rangers and warriors. We're now going to switch over to the pros and cons of each location, and I'll give you a ranking of the best armor setups to use for each one. Alright, so we'll start off with the Ireworth camp. The first pro of this place is that it's very Slayer friendly. It's probably one of the most popular places to do an elf Slayer task, and it's mostly because there are so many warriors and rangers for you to kill. Second pro is that you are allowed to use a cannon to help you. And the third pro is that it's a very accessible area even if you don't have the Ireworth camp teleports, and I'll make sure to show you how to run here in the location section. Anyways, the first con to this place is that if you use any armor setup with a cannon, it's going to attack both the rangers and the warriors in that area, meaning in order to use a cannon here, you not only need to have a high defense level, but you'll also need good armor to tank both the ranged and melee attacks. The other con to this place is that the tents in the area can sometimes block the cannon from firing at the elves behind it, so you will need to do some manual clicking from time to time so you're just not standing around. In terms of my armor setup ranking, the fastest way to do this task is to use a melee tank setup with a cannon, but like I mentioned before, I'd only recommend this setup if you're a very high level with very good gear. The second setup would be to use a melee range defense setup and just kill the rangers because of their slower attack interval. The third would be a melee stab defense armor setup and just attack the warriors, but I recommend this setup only if you're higher level. The fourth would be a melee prayer setup and just kill either the ranger or the warrior. And the fifth and sixth option would be a ranged prayer or a magic prayer setup and just kill either the ranger or the warrior. Now moving on to the second location, the Ireworth dungeon. The first pro to this place is that it's incredibly Slayer friendly, and there's lots of elves in a small area. The second pro is that there are only warriors here, so you have the ability to use a cannon and pretty much use any armor setup you want without worrying about being attacked by two different attack styles. The third pro is that you can use a cannon here. The fourth pro is that it's very accessible with lots of ways to travel here to the dungeon. And the fifth pro is that these elves are the only elves in RuneScape to drop the enhanced crystal teleport seed, and at the time of recording this video, it's currently worth about 2.5 million coins. The big con to this area is that it is locked by the Song of the Elves quest, so if you want to use this area, you'll need to complete that quest. In terms of my armor setup ranking, the best setup to use in my opinion is a melee prayer setup with a cannon. The second would be a ranged prayer setup with a cannon. Third would be a melee stab defense setup with a cannon. Fourth would be a magic prayer setup with a cannon. Fifth is a melee stab defense setup if you don't want to use a cannon. And the sixth would be to use one of the prayer setups and just have your protect from melee on while attacking them. And moving on to the third location, the Mourner headquarters. The one thing to note before I talk about the pros and cons is that if you completed the Song of the Elves quest, you will not be able to use this area. But anyways, the first pro to this area is that the area is extremely accessible if you have a Slayer ring. The second pro is that there are only warriors here, so you can pretty much wear any armor setup you want without being attacked by two different attack styles. The third pro is that you can use a cannon here to help speed up your Slayer task. And the fourth pro, to me at least, is that the warriors will be aggressive onto you as you enter the headquarters. Anyways, going on to the first con, if you don't have a Slayer ring, you will need to have the full Mourner's outfit, which is a total of 6 pieces. If you don't have the full Mourner's outfit, maybe because you dropped it or something, you'll have to kill the level 20 Mourner at the entrance of Arendar Gate and repair the top and trousers. It's not that hard to do, and if you want to read more about how to re-obtain the outfit, I posted the wiki link to Mourning's End Part 1 in the description box below. The other con to this area is that it's not great for Slayer XP. There are only 4 Mourner Elves in the basement, and they can also spawn in different rooms, meaning you'll have to do some running around in order to kill them. In terms of my armor setup ranking, the fastest way to me is by using a melee prayer setup with a cannon. The second option if you're a higher level player would be just to use a melee stab defense setup while also using a cannon. Third would just be a melee prayer setup without a cannon. The fourth would be a melee stab defense setup. And the fifth would be to either use a ranged prayer or a magic prayer setup and just have your protect from melee on while killing them. And on to the final location, Letya. The first pro is that it's very accessible with a teleport crystal. The second pro is that there's also a prayer altar in the eastern building on the second floor. The third pro for those who are playing on an Iron Man account is that there's also a bank nearby, as well as a food store that sells lobsters and cakes if you need to top up on anything. The fourth pro is that there's a safe spot for lower level players looking to use Ranger Magic, which I'll show you in the in-game example. And finally, you are allowed to use a cannon here to help you. The one con of this place is that it's not great for fast Slayer XP. There are only 3 elves roaming around Letya, a warrior and a ranger that spawn close near the west gate, and there's also another warrior that spawns on the northeastern side, so if you kill them too fast on the west side, you may have to do some waiting around before the west ones respawn. In terms of my armor setup ranking, I'd use a melee tank setup with a cannon if I was a higher level player. The second setup would be to use a melee tank setup and kill the warrior and ranger near the west gate. The third would be to either use a melee prayer, a ranged prayer, or a magic prayer setup, and just attack the warriors on the west and eastern side. And finally, for the lower level players, I would safe spot with a range prayer or the magic prayer setups. So hopefully that has given you an idea of which area and armor setup you want to use. Feel free to use the timestamps on the screen now to skip forward to your desired armor setup. So here's the melee tank armor chart, and I've ranked all the armors from best to least best to help maximize your defensive bonuses. Feel free to pause the video now to select your armor, and you can use the timestamp at the top right to skip forward when you're finished. Now here's the melee ranged defense armor chart, and I've ranked all the armors from best to least best to help maximize your ranged defense bonuses. Feel free to pause the video now to select your armor, and you can use the timestamp at the top right to skip forward when you're finished. Now here's the melee stab defense armor chart, and I've ranked all the armors from best to least best to help maximize your stab defensive bonuses. Feel free to pause the video now to select your armor, and you can use the timestamp at the top right to skip forward when you're finished. So here's the melee prayer armor chart, and I've ranked all the armors from best to least best to help maximize your melee and prayer bonuses. Feel free to pause the video now to select your armor, and you can use the timestamp at the top right to skip forward when you're finished. Here's the ranged prayer armor chart, and I've ranked all the armors from best to least best to help maximize your ranged and prayer bonuses. Feel free to pause the video now to select your armor, and you can use the timestamp at the top right to skip forward when you're finished. And finally, here's the magic prayer armor chart, and I've ranked all the armors from best to least best to help maximize your magic and prayer bonuses. Feel free to pause the video now to select your armor. So we're now moving on to location information, and I've broken up each location into 3 different parts. We'll talk about how to get there, what your inventory and quick pairs might look like, as well as an in-game example to get you going on your Slayer task. So we'll first go over how to travel to the first location, Ironworth Camp. Also, if you do travel with the options 2, 3, 4, or 5, you'll also need to bring an anti-poison with you. Anyways, the fastest way to get here is by using an Ironworth Camp teleport, and you can either buy it from the Grand Exchange or get them as a clue reward. The second fastest way is to use a charter ship to Port Tyrus. I've listed in blue the fastest ways to get yourself to a charter ship, and also ways to reduce the cost of taking a charter ship. The third method is by using a Fae Ring and going to BJS, but you will also need to have 76 agility or 71 with a Summer Pie boost to use this method of travel. The fourth method is to use a Zalandra teleport, and the fifth way is to either use a Necklace of Passage to the outpost or get yourself to the Tree Gnome stronghold and then run through the Arandar Gate and then head west through the forest until you get yourself here. So here are my inventory examples. Feel free to pause the video now to copy them for your attack style. And here are my quick pair examples for each attack style. Feel free to pause the video now to copy them. So here's the in-game example for the Ironworth Camp, and I've placed timestamps so you can skip forward to whichever part you'd like to watch. First, I'll show you how to run to the Ironworth Camp from the charter ship. So we'll start by running east and just follow me. So just take the path north and you want to head to the northern part of Tyrus Camp. You'll see three dense forests that you have to pass, so just click on it and your character will pass through. Once you're past, let's head north and then east. And then you want to head south. You'll see three dense forests that you have to pass, so just click on it and your character will pass through. And once you're past, just head south, and you'll see a tripwire. Just left-click it to pass the trap, and if the trap fires arrows at you, just drink a dose of your anti-poison. Anyways, you want to head east. And then you'll find some more dense forest, just pass that as well. And once you're past, you just want to head north, and then northwest, and just try your best to follow along with me. So along the way, you'll see a leaves trap, just right-click it and jump over the trap. If you fall down, you can just click the walls to climb out, but just keep heading north all the way to the Ironworth camp. And just cross the log balance to pass the river. And voila, here we are. So you can see that there are both archers and warriors in the area, and it's very easy to tell the difference between the two, but if you want them to be even more noticeable and you're also using the Runelite client, what you can do is click the arrow button on the top right of the application to pull up the sidebar. You'll want to click the wrench to access the configuration settings, and you can scroll down or type into the search bar NPC indicators, switch on the plugin, and also click the gear icon right next to it. And in the render style dropdown, make sure to have the highlight hull option ticked on, and where it says NPCs to highlight, type in the elf you're going to kill, whether it's the Ironworth Archer or the Ironworth Warrior, and make sure to not make any spelling mistakes here. By doing this, this will highlight the elf in the Runelite client that you want to kill, and it will allow you to see it a lot better. Alright, so we're now at the Ironworth camp, and you can see where I like to place my cannon down if you have one of those. Anyways, it's pretty easy to kill elves, but when you're ready, just drink a dose of your stat boosting potion, activate your quick prayers, have your auto retaliate on, if you're using magic, make sure to turn on your magic spell, and just attack the elves. And for the people that are using a melee range defense setup, focus on the archers. If you're using a melee stab defense setup, just attack the warriors. Elves will also drop sharks and bass from time to time, so make sure to pick those up so you can heal. Now going over how to travel to the Ironworth dungeon, and remember that this area can only be accessed after the Song of the Elves quest. The fastest way to get here is by exiting the Priftinus house portal and then heading southwest. You can do this by using a scroller redirection on a house tab with 70 construction, or relocating your house with an estate agent for 50,000 coins to Priftinus. The second fastest way to get here is by using a teleport crystal to Priftinus and then running southwest. You can also use a spirit tree to Priftinus and then run southwest. You can also travel here by using an Ironworth camp teleport, by running east past the dense tree obstacles, and then heading north to the gate, and then going to the southwestern part of the city. The final way is to use a charter ship to Priftiness, and I've listed in blue the fastest ways to get yourself to a charter ship, and also ways to reduce the cost of taking a ship. So here are my inventory examples, feel free to pause the video now to copy them for your attack style. And here are my quick pair examples for each attack style, feel free to pause the video now to copy them. So now I'll show you the in-game example for the Iowarth dungeon, and I've placed timestamps on the screen so you can follow along with me to get to the elves room. So climbing down into the dungeon, you'll see the agility obstacle just west of us, so just click to climb through. And once you're past, you can head southwest. And once the path breaks, take the path south. And voila, we're in the elves room. So climbing down into the dungeon, you can drink a dose of your stamina potion as well. And we're gonna take the path east and then northeast. So just head north into the Moss Giant's room, and you can also turn on your Protect from Magic on to reduce the damage taken. But just run northwest to exit the Moss Giant's room, and then head west. You'll see the path starting to head south into the Necro room, just head west and then head north to avoid the whole room. And then follow the path west, and then follow the path south. And once you see the agility obstacle on your mini-map, you can take the path southwest. And once the path breaks, you can take the path south. And voila, we're in the elves room. But yeah, it's pretty simple to kill elves once you're down here. I've marked where you can drop your cannon down if you have one. But when you're ready, just drink a dose of your stat boosting potions, activate your quick prayers, have your auto retaliate on. If you're using magic, make sure to turn on your magic spell, and just go ahead and attack the elves. And going on to the third location, the Mourner headquarters, and remember that if you're traveling with options 2 or 3, you'll need the full Mourner's outfit with you. But the fastest way to get here is by using a Slayer ring and teleporting to the Dark Beast, but with this method, you'll be teleported right inside the basement near the headquarters, so you don't actually need to bring the Mourner's outfit with you. The second fastest way is to teleport to West Ardoon, and you can either buy or make yourself a teleport tab, or you can also use a West Ardoon teleport spell in the Arceus spellbook. The third way to get here is to just enter through the East Gate of West Ardoon, and you can either buy or make yourself an Ardoon tab, use the teleport spell in the spellbook at level 51 magic, or you can also use an Ardoon cloak teleport. So here are my inventory examples, feel free to pause the video now to copy them for your attack style. And here are my quick pair examples for each attack style, feel free to pause the video now to copy them. So here's the in-game example for the Mourner headquarters, and just letting you know, I've already completed the Song of the Elves quest, so the NPCs inside the Mourner headquarters will look a little bit different than yours. Your elves will be called Mourner elves, and they will have plague masks walking around with crystal halberds. Anyways, you can put on your full Mourner outfit, and you have to take off everything except the ring and blessing. But once you have it on, you can go ahead and open the door to go through. And then you want to head to the west side of the building and climb down the basement trapdoor. Anyways, once you're down here, you can see where I like to place the cannon, which is in the southeast side. But yeah, when you're ready, you can go ahead and drink a dose of your stat boosting potion, activate your quick prayers, have your auto retaliate on. If you're using magic, make sure you also turn on your magic spell. And once you switch out your Mourner outfit, they'll start attacking you, and you can just go ahead and attack the elves. And going on to the final location, Letya. Also, if you're going to use options 2, 3, or 4 to travel here, you also need to bring an anti-poison with you. But the fastest way to get here is by using a teleport crystal to Letya. The second fastest way is to use a charter ship to Port Tyrus. I've listed in blue the fastest ways to get yourself to a charter ship, and also ways to reduce the cost of taking a charter ship. The third method is by using a Fair Ring to BJS, but you will need to have 76 agility or 71 with a Summer Pie boost to use this method of travel. And the fourth is just to use a Zalandra teleport. So here are my inventory examples, feel free to pause the video now to copy them for your attack style. And here are my quick pair examples for each attack style, feel free to pause the video now to copy them. So here's the in-game example for Letya. I placed timestamps so you can skip forward to whichever part you'd like to watch. So I'll show you how to run to Letya from the charter ship first. So we'll start by running east, and just follow me. So just take the path north, and you want to head to the northern part of Tyrus Camp. You'll see three dense forests that you have to pass, so just click on it and your character will pass through. Once Once you're past, let's head north and then east. And then you want to head south. You'll see three dense forests that you have to pass, so just click on it and your character will pass through. And once you're past, just head south and you'll see a tripwire. Just left click it to pass the trap. And if the trap fires arrows at you, just drink a dose of your anti-poison. Anyways, you want to head east. And then you'll find some more dense forest, just pass that as well. And once you're past, we want to head east. And then northeast. And you'll find a leaves trap. Just right click it and jump over the trap. If you fall down, you can just click the walls to climb out. But once you're over, you want to run northeast. And you'll find another tripwire, just left click it to climb over. And once you're past, just head northeast, past the dense forest again. And once you're past, just head south, and then east, and you'll be in Letya. And voila, here we are. Alright, so we're here at Letya. You can see where I like to drop my cannon down. You can also see that there will be one warrior and one ranger that spawn close to the west side of Letya. And there'll also be another warrior to the northeastern side, but sometimes they wander around a bit, so they may be off somewhere right now. But yeah, for those people who are not using safe spotting armors, you can go ahead and prepare by drinking your stat boosting potions, activate your quick prayers, have your auto retaliate on, and if you're using magic, make sure to turn on your magic spell, and just go ahead and attack the elves. So I'll just show you how to safe spot for the people who are using the safe spotting armors, but you want to use the bench right near the entrance on the west side, and you want to get the warrior stuck, so I would just attack it to lure it, stand behind the bench, and then you can go ahead and kill it. Once you kill it, just wait for the warrior to respawn, and just rinse and repeat the process. Anyways guys, I'm going to end the guide here. If this video has helped you out and you want to help me out as well, I'd greatly appreciate it if you could leave a like on the video and subscribe to the channel. And remember, if you're doing more Slayer tasks, make sure to check out my other Slayer guides in the description box below. But that's just about it. Thanks guys for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Later!